Hey guys, what is going on location out here in Tirana, Albania? And today, we are going down into a nuclear bunker and then up a pyramid. Was a lunatic. He was also the communist dictator of Albania from the year 1941 till his death in 1985. And during that time, he was so paranoid about other countries like Yugoslavia, Greece, and even Soviet allies coming in and attacking Albania, he made over 173,000 bunkers around the country. The construction of these made it one of the poorest countries in Europe, and they were never even used. So today, two of the largest bunkers made are here in the capital, and they've been made into museums and art galleries. We're gonna go check one of them out. Across the street, we have the entrance to Bunk'Art 2. That is where we are going. A bunker right here in the middle of Tirana. If there was a nuclear attack, I had to live down here with this many people. I'd leave. I'd go out. Oh, this is kind of a cool room. Minister's bedroom. Well, it ain't the Hilton. Not awesome. Picture of Ebner Hoxha. He actually died before this specific bunker was finished. Oh, they're just books that he wrote. Barbershop. Better hope you like the barber down here. Whoa. You gotta be kidding me, this whole place is packed and I got this whole room to myself. Looks like the first kind of art piece. That's the exit entrance right over there. So all that is underground, which is kind of fascinating. I didn't see much art, and it was kind of tough to read up on the history and focus on the history with it being so cramped with people. It is Saturday, so I think it's maybe not the best day.
Hello.
Hey, man.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Oh, USA.
Yeah.
Beautiful country.
Hey, thank you. I like Albania also.
You like us. We like you because you are a big country and a very friendly relationship with
us. Yeah. Taking videos of all the sites.
Take a video. You alone or together with anyone?
With you, man.
Okay, just, nice. Yeah. Can we walk a little?
Sure. You
wanna, okay, we'll go.
Tell me something about this.
No, I don't like.
Oh, you don't want to be on?
I don't like YouTube.
Ah, okay.
Is YouTube?
Okay. Yeah. So, that guy didn't want to be on camera, but he wanted to hang out with me the entire day and talking about all these places that we were going to go, but he kept also asking if I was recording and all. So I just was trying to get away from him. turns out he just wanted 2 euros. So I gave him the 2 euros so I could show you guys this. This is the Pyramid of Tirana. It was built in 1988. And I think the architect was Enver Hoxha's daughter. This was originally a museum for him. And it got turned into, I think 1999, it was a NATO base during the Kosovo conflict. And now it is an IT youth center, I think, for kind of teaching kids coding and robotics and stuff like that. It used to be all tile, and you could get up to the top, but it was very slippery. So May of this year, 2023, it was just re-released as this Pyramid of Tirana. Made it to the top of the pyramid. My phone is shutting down because of overheating. It is pretty hot out here in Albania. It's not the first time this has happened. This happened at the military parade in Poland. These guys must be absolutely dying. Good news is that ambulance left. The bad news is my phone is getting overheating warnings because it's so hot. And while we're up here, let's take a look at the view of the city. It's a very beautiful, colorful city with mountains in the background. And that's not usually the case for a lot of these communist countries. But what happened was Edi Rama was the mayor of Tirana from 2000 to 2011. And he was a former painter. So he wanted to spruce the city up. He had a lot of campaigns to add some color and some life to it. So you just see a lot of very colorful buildings all over the place. Interesting architecture. Edi Rama is actually the current prime minister of Albania. So he's having a pretty successful career. We've stumbled upon some kind of festival. This is Skanderbeg Square, and that is the monument dedicated to Skanderbeg. And apparently he was a hero in the 14th century and fought off the Ottomans. So we're gonna check out the festival in his square here. It looks like it's a TiranAgro food and fest. Oh, TiranAgro Food and Fest. They did the double A thing. They combined it. Dig the clothing. Got some big fans of scarves here. A little bit surprising is how hot I am. Just burning up. Yeah, parts of this, it's just like a farmer's market. Along the corner of the Skanderbeg Square, we have the National Historical Museum with what I would consider to be a pretty awesome mosaic. Represents the different eras of Albania from the Roman times, Byzantines, Ottomans, communism. And if we take a look at the flag over here, the symbol on it is a double-headed eagle, which is what Skanderbeg had on his flag when he was rallying the troops and bringing the people of Albania together to fight against the Ottomans. Well, that's kind of interesting. It's like a bird made out of a nest. Oh, so check this out. It's a fruit stand. You can buy fruit here, but there is something interesting about this. Bananas. So Bananas were unavailable in Albania until 1992. So they've only had bananas here for about 30 years. And apparently when the bananas arrived, a lot of the older Albanians did not want to even try it. They had to keep the bananas behind glass because it was extremely rare and valuable. So now, as you can see, bananas are out in the open, sold, easily available. We have a market up ahead. Let's see what's for sale up here. I see more bananas. Got a lot of Albania gear, as you'd expect. Hats, t-shirts. Clock here. Got the Albania double eagle ring, double-headed eagle ring. Got the half-drank beer for sale. Actually not sure what these are. What is this vodka? Is this vodka? What is it? Yapa? Raki. Oh, okay. What's Raki?
Raki je pija te regulone punon kamera per bugoripas.
I have no idea, but.
Brandy.
Yeah. What's this? What's Raki?
Raki.
It's good?
Good. Yeah. Don't have provost. Hadi. Hadi provost Raki. Put it on Raki. Hadi.
All right. How much is a Raki? How much?
How much? Five up here. No. Six.
Six? What's the best one? I just want a little one. Small. Six is for the small one?
Yeah, six.
All right. Yeah, give me a Raki.
Raki, yeah. So it's Raki.
It's good? Okay. Okay. Okay, so six. My man. All right. Hey, thank you.
Thank you very much.
What is in Albanian? Thank you.
Albania.
Yeah. How do you say thank you? All right. Well, thank you, sir. It's not the busiest day at the market here. Everybody's falling asleep. But we're gonna try out this Raki. I just looked it up. It is the traditional drink of Albania. It's like a brandy. That's made from raisins or grapes, so let's give it a shot. So here it is. It is 42% alcohol. It has the Albanian seal on it. Going out of focus a bit. Let's give it a try. All right, here it is. Dang, it's got a bite. It's good. It's good, man. You want some? Do you want? No? You gotta work? It's good. Very, very strong. Oh, more stuff. Now that I've drank a bit, you want me to get more stuff. All right, let's see, what do you got? It's all this guy's stuff. Hey, hello. Oh, glasses. Let's see what else we got out here. Ooh. tobacco. Yeah. It's all just tobacco. Oh. Tobacco, yeah? Cigarette? Huh, well, for the pipes, I quit. Should probably try some traditional food, but I don't know if any of these places take card. We're running out of cash a bit. I guess I'll have to ask one of these places. I asked him what is some local food, and he said traditional food. So that's what I ordered. I gotta figure out what it's actually. I don't think the name is actually traditional food. I got my glass of wine here. When I've had wine and I ask, you know, what kind of wine do you have? They say red or white. So I've gone ahead and gotten the red wine. Brought out some bread. And this soup, try not to spill it. He said it's traditional soup, and I asked for the name. He said it's lavaleo. Lavaleo. I'm gonna have to look this up. It's got meat, cheese, I think cream. Meat, something. Meatballs. Lavaleo. Pretty good. Pretty good. I don't think I specified the meat in the soup that I already forgot the name of is beef. It was delicious. Now I'm waiting on some chicken dish. All right, I'm gonna have my guy help me out here. Can you tell me this one again?
Fileto pule me garniture.
Fileto pule
me garniture.
Me garniture. Fileto pule me garniture. Yeah, all right.
Enjoy.
So it's like a chicken fillet, got sour cream. It's a Mediterranean salad, French fries. It's got the lemon. I actually already tried it, very good, but I gotta try it again. With the yummy face, right? Very good. I have to say, there are a lot of negative stereotypes about Albania and Albanians, and I don't think any of them are true. I heard people saying that it was dangerous to come here. Here? If you think this is dangerous, do not leave your house. The people here are some of the friendliest people I've ever come across. Everyone's been very helpful. People I don't even know have tried to help me out, haven't gotten scammed or anything. It's been great. And with that, we're gonna end this one, and I will see you guys in the next episode.